Hi my dear students, welcome back to Gurudeva online class. Dear student, in the last class we had discussed the few important points about the Australia continent, like the location of Australia continent, extent of Australia continent, physical setting, physical division, river system, and as well as climate of Australia continent. So today we are going to extend that lesson. Today we are going to discuss the few important points. Those are the first one, natural vegetation, wildlife, agricultural and animal husbandry, minerals and industries, and the last one, population of Australia continent. So let us discuss one by one. In the first one, natural vegetation. Dear student, the Australia continent, almost all it has scarcity of forest. So almost all this Australia continent, it occupy the with grassland, shrubs and open woodland. Then what are the important natural vegetations we can see in the Australia continent? The overall natural vegetations we are going to divide into the five important parts. Those are the first one, tropical forest. Second one, temperate forest. The third one, grassland. Fourth one, shrub land. And the fifth one, desert vegetation. Now let us discuss one by one. In that first one, tropical forest. The tropical forest also, it is also one of the very important natural vegetation of Australia continent. And where it is located? It is located in the northern and northeast part of Australia continent. And what are the important trees we can found in this tropical forest? Those are palm tree, ash, leech and cedar. These are the a few important trees we can found in tropical forest. And the next, the second natural vegetation of Australia continent, that temperate forest. This temperate forest we can found in the place of Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria and Tasmania. Then what are the important trees we can see in the place of temperate forest? Those are eucalyptus, acacia, pine, coal trees. These are the a few important trees we can see in the temperate forest. In that especially the eucalyptus, this we can use for the oil and paper making. So this is about the second natural vegetation, that temperate forest. Let us discuss the third natural vegetation of Australia continent, that grassland. So this grassland, again we are going to divide into the two important parts. The first one, tropical grassland. The tropical grassland we can call also savanna grassland. And the second one, temperate grassland. This temperate grassland we can call also downs. In that first one, the tropical grassland, and I said that we can call also savanna. So where we can see this tropical grassland? In the place of Queensland, central of North Australia and West Australia. And also I said that in the beginning, this tropical grassland we can call also savanna grassland. And the second one, temperate grassland. This temperate grassland we can call also down. So where we can see this temperate grassland? In the place of Murray Darling Basin. And this is used for the pastoral activities. Here we can see the three important basin, Tussock, Mitchell and Astrebel. These are the three important basin we can see in the Murray Darling Basin. The Tussock, it is very useful for the sheep rearing. And next, fourth one, natural vegetation of Australia continent, that shrub land. So this is located in the southern and western part of Western Australia. The few important places like New South Wales and Queensland. So here we can see the shrub land. The few important trees we can find in the shrub land, those are shrubs, acacia, eucalyptus, cactus and thorny plants. So this is about the shrub land. The fifth natural vegetation, that desert vegetation. My dear student, I said that the Australia, it almost all occupy the desert area. So here we can see a very less rainfall. And this desert vegetation mainly we can see in the place of central and eastern part of the Western Australia. Here the few important trees are cactus, thorny bushes and grass. So this is about the fifth natural vegetation, that desert vegetation. So these are the a very important natural vegetation we can see in the Australia continent. The next we can discuss about the wildlife of Australia continent. The wild of Australia continent, it is very strange and unique. Here we can see a very variety types of bird and as well as animal also. So let us discuss which are the important animals and birds we can see in the Australia continent. The overall wildlife of Australia continent we are going to divide into the three important parts. The first one, carnivorous animals, marsupials animals, and the third one, egg-laying animals. In the first one, carnivorous animal, here we can see the few important animals like dingo, numbut, quail, and Tasmanian devil. And the next one, marsupials animals. So here, kangaroo, wallabies, koala, and wombat. So these are the a few important marsupials animal. And here the kangaroo, dear student, as you know that the kangaroo, it is the national animal of Australia. Third one, egg laying animals. Here we can see the two important animal, the first one platypus and the second one is echidna. So these are the a wild life of Australia continent. Let us discuss what are the important birds we can see in the Australia continent. Those are emu bird, black swan, lyrebird, kookaburra, and carvings. These are the a few important birds we can see in the Australia continent. Among those, emu, it is the large and flightless bird. And also the lyrebird. The lyrebird, it resembles beautiful peacock. And also the kookaburra. The kookaburra, when it is going to make a sound, it looks like a human laugher. And also in the Australia continent, we can see very dangerous and poisonous snakes also. So this is about the wildlife and birds of Australia continent. Let's discuss agricultural and animal husbandry of Australia continent. Dear student, the agriculture also, it is one of the very important occupation of Australia continent. But here we can see a very less for the cultivated land. Because of, I said that in the beginning class, almost all Australia continent, it is covered by the desert area. Only 4% of cultivable land we can see in the Australia continent. In that especially in the coastal plains and river basin. This is for the suitable for cultivation of land. And the only 4.4% people engaged in the agricultural field. Let us discuss what are the important crops we can see in the Australia continent. Wheat, sugarcane, cotton, maize, and tobacco. And with this in Australia, we can see the few important fruits also in the different places like Queensland, New South Wales, and Victoria. So here the few important fruits like orange, guava, and apple. So let us discuss one by one. In that first one, wheat. The wheat, especially this wheat crops, we can see in the place of South Australia, Queensland, New South Wales, and Victoria. And one more important basin, that Murray Darling Basin. So here we can see the large area of wheat crop. And the Australia continent, among the 100, the 70% it is going to export of wheat. And next, one more important crop, that maize. The maize, it grow in the two important places, those are Queensland and New South Wales. The next one, rice. Rice, it grow in the place of Murray Darling Basin and Queensland. And the next one crop, sugarcane. This sugarcane we can see in the two important places, New South Wales and Queensland. And the third one, tobacco. The tobacco, it grow in the place of Queensland. So these are the a few important crops we can see in the Australia continent. And the next, the one more important topic, that animal husbandry. So it is also one of the very important occupation of Australia continent. Here we can see cattle and sheep rearing. These are the two important rearing we can see in the Australia continent. And it is the popular for the coastal activities of sheep and cattle reared for the wool, meat, skin, and as well as dairy product. In that, the sheep is the leading producer and export of wool in the world. And also the sheep are raised on loose farms called the stations. And among 100, the 70% of Australia are merino type of sheep rearing. Why the sheep rearing is a very important occupation in the Australia continent? Because of here we can see vast grassland and artesian swell and cool dry climate and wide market facilities. Because of this we can see the one of the very important sheep rearing in the Australia continent. One more important point, minerals. The Australia it has a use minerals. So let us discuss what are the important minerals we can see in the Australia continent. Those are iron ore, bauxite, lead, zinc, copper, nickel, tin, uranium, coal, petroleum and natural gas. So these are the a few important minerals we can see in the Australia continent. In that first one, iron ore. The iron ore centers like Iron Knob, Iron Monarch, Iron Baron Hill and Pilliber and Ampi. So these are the effects of iron ore. And bauxite. The bauxite we can see in the place of Weipa, Goa and Mitchell Plateaus. And Australia, it is the world largest producer of bauxite. And the next one, gold. The gold also, it is also one of the very important minerals in Australia continent. In this gold, we can see in the place of New South Wales and as well as Victoria and Queensland. And the next one, lead and zinc. The lead and zinc we can see in the a few important places. Those are New South Wales, Queensland, Tasmania and Arthur Rivers Basin. In these places we can see the lead and zinc. The next one more important mineral is that copper. The copper we can see in the two important places. The first one, New South Wales and the next one is Gulf of Carpentaria. And the next one more important minerals that uranium. The uranium we can see the two important places. The first one, West and South Australia. And the next one, Queensland. So the next one, coal and petroleum. The coal and petroleum available in the places of New South Wales, Queensland and Victoria. The next one, the natural gas. The natural gas, it is available in the places of Dongre, Bastrite, Roma and one more important place that Marsena. And these are the important minerals we can see in the place of Australia continent. Yes. The Australia, it has many industry also. Dear student, as you know that the Australia, it is very well in the agricultural and also it is well in the minerals also and it is developed in the science and technology also. So that the Australia continent, it has many industries. The few important industries are the first one, iron and steel industry, automobile industry, shipbuilding, electrical machinery, textiles, paper and paper, board, oil refining and the next one, aircraft and floor milling and chemical industry. These are the a few important industries we can see in the Australia continent. The next one, populations. My dear student, as you know that the Australia it is smallest continent area and as well as population also. The Australia during the 2012 it has 20.0 millions. So this which accounts for the only 0.31% of the world's populations. And if you see in the 1860, it has 1.15 million population. And the next, if you see 1998, the Australia population, it has 18.7 millions. So it indicates that every year the Australia population is growth. The next one, distributions of population. The highest population we can see in the New South Wales. The next highest population we can see in the Victoria. The almost all among 100, the 50% of population it is located in the six capital cities. Those are the first one, Sydney, Melbourne, Brisbane, Adelaide, Perth and Newcastle. So these are the six important capital cities we can see the high populations. The next one, the density of population. The Australia is a very low density populations in the world. The average density of population in the Australia 3 person per square kilometers. And the highest density we can see the few important places. Those are Victoria, New South Wales, Queensland and Tasmania. And the less density in the desert area, because of those places it covered by the desert area, this is not suitable for leading the life. And also almost all the urban population it has 85% and the rural population it has 15%. So this is about the density population of Australia
continent.
Yes, my dear student, this is the lesson about the Australia continent. Dear student, in this class, we discussed the few important points. Those are natural vegetation of Australia continent, wildlife of Australia continent, agricultural and animal husbandry of Australia continent, minerals and industries of Australia continent, and the last point we discussed that populations of Australia continent. We will meet in the next class. Bye, my dear students.